Hi guys, DC Breaks here. Welcome to the DBS Institute YouTube channel. In this video, I'm going to be exploring a piece of software from RipX called DeepRemix, which is an advanced AI-powered stem separation-based technology. It offers quite a lot more than some of the other AI stem separation technologies I've covered in other videos, such as Lalal and Database. So let's jump on in and take a look at how it works. So this is the DeepRemix environment. It's a standalone piece of software. It doesn't integrate yet with a DAW. The way it's laid out on the left at the top here, we have our rips. Rips are essentially the file format container. It's a .rip file format that contains all the information that we'll see from any track that we put into DeepRemix. Below that, we've got all of our layers. We'll see more about those in just a moment. There's a really useful interactive help tool as well, particularly as it can get quite busy on the screen, as we'll see shortly. And on the right, we've got a whole bunch of processing that we can use on our tracks as well. So to use it, it's really straightforward. We simply click here or drag in a file that we want to use. In a previous video, I had a look at a service called lalal.ai, which is an online-based service. So I'm going to use the same track by way of comparison, which is a track called We Never Slow Down by DC Breaks and features Eva Lazarus. When you bring in a track, it asks you what you want to rip, and for quickest results, only select what you need. So if I was to do a full rip on this, you know, we're looking at like 17 minutes. So fortunately, I've already ripped this particular track. And if I double click on our rip here, we can see what it does. So this is what you get when you open up your rip. And by way of explanation, what's going on here is that it's taken each of the individual layers and separated them out. And we can now view and edit each of these separately. So at the moment we're looking at the master, so this is everything together. Let's have a quick listen to see how that sounds. So if we just zoom in a little bit as well, you'll see kind of what's going on. It's basically playing each of the different stems that it's separated out, but obviously with the master it's playing all of them. So if we want to just, for example, listen to the voice, we can hit the solo button, and I'm just going to zoom out a little bit here as well. It's a little bit fiddly to do with the magic mouse. Real D's, keep it stacking. They don't know what that is. A different cloth, another fabric, classics, levels, we're honey, I am penthouse jamming. So what we can do is we can click on individual parts that it's ripped out. Only that I'm back in. To kind of preview those, but then for any one of these sort of parts, we can then you know, manipulate it in a huge amount of different ways, and we can kind of make multiple selections to do that as well. So for example, that selection there, I could click and drag to move it up a semitone. I'm just going to undo that. We can also kind of take a little part and drag it out and change its length if we want to. So it offers some quite interesting sound design possibilities as well. Or we can use any of the kind of processing over here. So we've got some different pitch controls. We can add vibrato, for example, or we could flatten pitch. So let's say we had a section like this. We could try flattening that down. And you'll see it kind of pulls out the kind of the pitch in it. Or conversely, if we undo that, we could add vibrato instead. Very extreme example, just to get an idea. We can do things like invert the pitch, slide the pitch, shift the pitch. And it's a little bit like Melodyne, if you've ever used that, in terms of the kind of depth that you can go into to manipulate the vocal stem as well. We could also pitch it to the scale. So to do that, we actually need to set the musical scale first. If we don't know what it is, we can come down to set musical scale and we can detect it. So it says that this vocal is in E minor, E harmonic minor. So if we select everything and go pitch to scale, we can use this to kind of auto-tune the voice or every single part of it to be rigidly stuck to that scale. And so we get some kind of interesting auto-tuney type of effects there as well. Just going to undo that. I'm not going to go into every single one of these modules, but you can kind of get a feel for how deep you can kind of dive into this if you want to. There's also some time-based effects. We've got reverb, delay, we can reverse different parts as well. And again, this can be for an individual part, or it can be for a multi-selection as well. And then we've got some different level tools, so we can adjust the gain of individual parts, adjust the pan, we can apply low and high pass filters, and there's also some presets for particular notes where we can do fade-ins, adding harmonies, vibrato and reverb and things like that as well. So for each stem, we can also monitor the stereo, but also the low, mid and high channels, and we can make multiple selections. And if we find different parts in the stem that haven't ripped correctly, like in other AI tool separation things, it doesn't give you that ability to kind of manually edit what it rips. So if I find a section here where there's some music going on, the chances are it might have sort of thought, oh, maybe that synth is a voice because it's in the same kind of range, and accidentally put it on the voice stem. I can't even remember when we made this tune. It might even been that this was based off a vocal itself, which is possibly why it's been picked up as being part of the voice. So if you wanted to kind of take those parts out, I'm just going to do a quick selection. Let's say it's those parts there. I could just select them. I could cut. I could add in a new layer. Let's call it, let's go for a synth layer. Select a synth layer and then paste it into that channel instead. And so that way, when we come to export everything, those parts wouldn't be on the vocal stem, for example. So we can really go in and clean everything up if we need to at quite a granular level. The other thing this is really great for is doing a kind of analysis of a track as well. So let's just go back to our master view. And it might be that, for example, we want to analyze how a bassline is being constructed in a tune, for example. So we could come down and look at the bass here. And we can literally hover over each note, and you can see on the left here what key it's in. So we know it's an E1, F sharp 1, G1, A1. We could also use this for sampling. So there might be some sounds in here that we really like that we wouldn't be able to cleanly sample typically because it would be cluttered by other layers. So we might want this bass sound, for example. So we can use this as a way to resample otherwise kind of hidden parts of a track, if you like, or cluttered parts of a track. So that opens up loads of different kind of remixing and sampling possibilities there as well. We can also use this to, as I've already shown you, kind of detect the keys of different parts. So we can detect the key of the whole track, which is saying it's D major, for example. We get the BPM, the kind of musical pattern for it as well. And there's just a huge amount that we can do. Like, we could change the whole timing of the whole track by selecting all and kind of using these warp things, for example. And so really the creative possibilities are quite endless, and it offers a lot more than other standard stem separation based technologies that I've looked at in some of my other videos. So when we're ready and we finished kind of editing and adjusting which layers we want and things like that, we can just come up to file and export, and then we can export everything, and we can choose the file format, the sample rate, and what we're going to actually export. So we can export a full rip, we can select different time or notes or regions, and then we can also export that as a single file. So for example, we might create an instrumental version and we just want to bounce out everything except for the voice, for example. Or we can go ahead and export it as separate stems, in which case we'll get all of those separate stems or even all the separate layers as audio files as well. So again, a huge amount of flexibility in terms of how we take all of that information and export it out of the project too. So that's DeepRemix in a nutshell. Let me know what you think in the comments below. If you like this video, hit that like and subscribe button to get more videos from us here at DBS delivered straight to your inbox. But that's it for this video, and I'll see you in the next one.